So this is like our third time to use a grill on this thing. We're using it this time because, well, these are steaks, because our grill that's behind that tree right there is so rotted out on the bottom you can't even build a fire in it. The ground pit over there has no grill in it. So we are down to, we are using our grill. Number three, it's working. Happy 4th of July. We're at the lake. I think this weekend we're gonna finally do a 1 year, 4 month, 1 year, 5 month, whatever it is, review of the Viking 9.0. All right guys, the plus for the Viking 9.0 is size, weight, ease of use. Everything on this thing is easy. It comes in at 1180 empty weight. Right now we are setting around 1500 pounds and we are pulling it with a four cylinder, 2.4 four cylinder, which is, it does a good job. The bad parts about the Viking is the size. It is small. If it wasn't just my wife and I and the dog, we really would have a problem if there was any more people. So the 9.0 is not for everyone. It is good for two people with a small dog. Okay, we got everything set up and lights going. Figured out how to turn the parking lights on and run those while we're parked. We added a solar panel onto this particular trailer. It's a 100 watt. You can see it on the roof along with the pinwheel. Along with the pinwheel that's running. This is the solar panel controller right here. The solar panel actually operates the controller right there. So if the sun's not out, the controller goes off so it doesn't waste your power in your battery. When the sun's up, this controller kicks in and shows you what you're charging. Here is Glossia's setup for 4th of July and for Texas. Now on this particular trip, I saw a tip, if you will, on Instagram from someone who also has a travel trailer that showed how to do this. If you stick a fuse in the right plugs on your plug, on your pigtail, the running lights will stay on. So we are using the running lights on the trailer for night lights. The great part about it is the license plate light is a porch light. So on the Viking trailers, they have these blue lights that you see here. They're LED and one is over the grill, which is obvious. And then they light up the speakers with these blue lights. The problem is they're not bright enough to see very well with. Coachman puts this trailer as an off-road trailer just because they put these big old honking tires on here. They actually don't push anything or pull anything. The problem is whenever they put these big tires on here, they want you to think that it's off-road. Whenever you fold this step up, it is not an off-road vehicle. That step will drag off in a heartbeat if you get too rough with this trailer. So all in all, would I recommend the Viking 9.0? For two people and a small dog, yes. In a heartbeat, I would recommend this trailer. For a family of three, maybe even four, I would be looking at the 12.0. 12.0 has a gaucho in it. It has a full bed. It has a side door on it. Which you can use that trailer as a teardrop or a pop-up style, which basically I think these things are hybrids. It's a teardrop pop-up. This one has just enough room in it for Glossia, I, and Floki. Without a problem, It is comfortable. The AC keeps it cold. The heater keeps it warm. Drawback to these trailers is they give you a screened-in room with the trailer. And even though we tried and tried and tried to put it on this trailer property, we never could. So we switched over to just a shade, got two pop-ups. Just at the end of August, we were looking at trying to make our way to Mount Rushmore, up into Montana, Wyoming, back down into Salt Lake City, and then back down into Colorado to Ouray, to the KOA there that's in between, or right there by some passes that I want to go see, and the True Grit Cafe, Yahoo John Wayne. So for this episode, we are done. That's what we have. That's where we are. We'll catch y'all later. Later, y'all.